Hi, this is John here. I want to take a minute and go over a really unique project that is curved multi-direction. And it was originally specified as pre-curved structural framing. And you know, we looked at it as how could we simplify this and frame this out of our FRAMEALL system. We've done some similar projects where a regular FRAMEALL on a 4x4 pattern, we were able to achieve these radiuses because they were so big, 200-300 foot radiuses. This job, the radiuses were a little tighter, so we needed to shrink our module down to 3x3 wire spacing, main spacing. And what's unique about this is we're not curving this curved ceiling down on the ground. We're doing the work up in the air. You see the guy up on the lift, and we're curving this by setting the height of the hanger wire. And it's really unique. And then this Felwich construction got one step further and got Hilti involved with their new PLT 300. And that's laying out the 3x3 grid off of our shop drawings. And then they're able to set the height of the hanger wire with a prism. And it's all being set by the Hilti PLT 300. And you'll see the ceiling forming itself. Really simplified this ceiling. So here you can see this ceiling, all the different elevations. It's coming, it's rolling up, back down, and you can see that it curving in both directions. So here's an example of the Armstrong shop drawing that, you know, that we got going on this project. And what you're looking at is here is main runners and FRAMEALL, 3 foot FRAMEALL cross tees. So it's a 3x3 grid pattern. Those are all hang points. And on these hang points are elevations. So then with this information plugged into the PLT 300 Hilti, they're able to lay out all the hang points, all the wires, they plumb up, and they can also set the height of the hanger wire to achieve this multi-curve ceiling. And that's how they're forming it up in the air. You can see, here's a little section cut. Normally our RC2 clips are more throughout the main. We only have them at the hanger wire, and that's what's forming the curve. And they'll reinforce these mains to hold the curve once the height is set by the hanger by snipping the main and reinforcing at the main wire with our RC2 clip.
Hey, I'm here with Dave Yop. He's project engineer on this project with Felwich. He's gonna walk us through how the Hilti P300 total station is used efficiently and effectively to lay out all these drywall grid hanging points.
So what I'm doing now is locking the laser onto this prism. And then we come back to one of our points, point 631. We shoot the wire from these points. So 631 on the floor would be 631 on the ceiling. Shoot the wire, and then we put the wire through this prism and we hold the bottom of it, mark the top, and then we bend the wire at that point. And if you look on this screen right here, you can see I'm 3 inches away and 8 inches away. So then I would have to move my laser, or the prism, I'm sorry, towards that point. And then that other number, the 11 foot, is our elevation. And we can use that to ride it up. And then once we get to our zero, we make a mark and we bend our wire. And that's where we sit. And we have an inch and a half offset for finish. And then after that's done, you'd move to the next point and it'll automatically jump to it. And then you can get centered over that. It's a lot easier when you're actually doing it. And then that 9'11½" is my elevation. We run our wire through, we take our elevation up. And once we get to our zero, that's actually a 2-inch offset for finish. We'll mark the top of this, we'll pull it back through, and then we'll bend the wire. And then that's where our framing connects.
This is our PLT 300. It's a camera-based total station. The same total stations you've seen for years. We've introduced a camera to it to do some cool stuff. But the biggest thing is we can take this information that we get from Armstrong, work with the contractor, and do a lot of really cool stuff, three-dimensionally even.
So Felwich has a BIM coordinator that takes our information from our shop drawings, and then he feeds it into your little handheld computer?
Yeah, yeah. So it started with the information that you guys provided.
Right.
We took a look at the plan. We talked about how it could work, came up with some ideas. And then Jared in the office, he went through it and he just sort of organized it all in a spreadsheet, which is what we need before we can import it into our tablet. And then the total station takes over from there. And it really allows us to work in 3D. We were able to take that prism, slide it right over the wire and tell those guys right where to bend it, make it relatively effortless. You know, I have to say, I wasn't the one here doing the install, but it seemed like it went almost too easy.
Yeah.
And I really have to give a lot of credit to Fowlwich and Armstrong. I was here to help them organize the information and get it going, but just the teamwork and the cohesiveness made this thing work really, really well. It's kind of the dream that we're talking about in construction, working together, you know? So with point overlay, we can actually use the camera and the tool and overlay the points on it. And so you can see that the guys with Fowlwich did a fantastic job getting this grid aligned.
So we're actually looking through a camera on the P300 at our drywall grid.
Yep.
And then we're seeing the points.
Yep.
Based on, because it knows where the points are because it's been calibrated to this job.
Yep, exactly right. So they're all laid out in there. And when we started this project, we could actually determine before we even got started that this duct was too low. So before they even shot a wire, we went and found the HVAC guys and had to move that duct because it was gonna be too low. So we were solving problems before they even started, which is great.
So if you want to learn more about how Armstrong FRAMEALL Drywall Grid can help simplify your next compound curved project, visit armstrongceilings.com/FRAMEALL.